Right, hello people. This is just another update on what's been going on with my little escapades with the with Great Yarmouth Council. I've been getting a lot of questions as well. Well, I think I'll try and answer. I'm not that clever when it comes to the old typing. So I'll be there all bloody week trying to answer your questions. Right, what can I remember? Questions. The Health and Safety Executive. Yes, we did try. We got in touch with them the first day after the... on the day of the asbestos saga. We phoned them up and basically they told us that they won't get involved until the council have done their own investigations. But if we weren't happy with their investigations, to get back in touch with them, which we did the next day, and basically they told us that they're not going to get involved. I don't know if it's secret handshakes going on or whatever, but they just did not want to know. They didn't want to get involved. What's the other questions I've had? I've got questions about have I got any photos of the mould and all the rest of it. We have. I found one that's got a couple of pictures on it, of one of the cameras, but we've got a load of stuff down in the shed, which all come from the old house, and I've got some memory sticks and all that down there with a lot of bits and pieces on them. But to be honest with you people, I really don't want to go down the shed because it absolutely stinks of the old house and it's vile, absolutely vile. And I need to get in touch with the Jesus of Kayaking, see if I can borrow one of his gas masks before I go in there, because it absolutely reeks people, and everything we had from the old house is in the shed. We would never bring it into this new house, as obviously this would all stink. We've had some more letters from the bailiffs saying that they're going to come round and they're going to do this and do that. I'm not really worried about bailiffs because at the end of the day there's no way they're getting in my house, so I'm really bothered about them. They come and knock all fucking day and they ain't going to get fuck all. Well, I ain't got fuck all to give them. The council have had it all. I should send them down to the council, let them get it off of them, shouldn't I really? But we have had a visit from NORSE, which are the council workmen. They come round here to basically, they sent a little bloke round who I'll call him Stretch. Alright? He's about 3 foot tall, he's a supervisor. Well, they sent him round to see about an old job that's supposed to have been done. Well, what happened, I'll just quickly explain that. In February, we contacted the council because we had them bad winds, and wind was blowing straight through basically one of our windows because it's bowed, so it isn't sitting in the gap properly. And we phoned them up in February. We phoned them about 8 times in February. No one come round. We phoned again in March. And the young lady told me that there's no way that they could get anyone to us in March, but they'll try and get someone to come to our house on the 15th of April. 15th of April went, no one still turned up. And about 3 or 4 days ago, this little Stretch turned up to see about another job, and basically I told him that the window was still stuffed in the front room and no one's been, and he said alright then I'll look into that and get someone to come round. So I thought fair enough, you know, we've waited years for them to repair stuff before, so we'll wait another fucking few days, you know what I mean, it made no odds to us. Well anyway, they sent 2 blokes round. One of them, the old boy, I do believe his name was Terry. Sweet as a nut, lovely bloke. Well, the other fella they had with him was, I'd say he was late 20s, early 30s. Well, this bloke had a right problem. You know, he was quite a nasty little herbert. We got into a bit of a row because it was all over the videos. Because he's obviously heard about them or seen them, so he had a right problem with it, right? Because I was exposing them basically. Well, anyway, he's gone and got back in his van. The bloke I'm telling you about, he went and got back in his van, and about half hour later, Stretch turned up. He come in, and we started talking about the videos. Now, he explained to me that he had never watched them, but he had a lot of information about them. And he started rattling on about his man that was in the video. And I tried to explain to him that it was never about the man. It was about the hole that had been in my floor for 2.5 years. And how I just wanted to show people what was going on. So it was never about his man. Well, he had a big old problem. Oh yeah, it's my man, blah, blah, blah. And I turned around and said to him, look mate, I said, we went through the ringer, me and my family went through the ringer for 4.5 years, right? You know all the information, you know everything about it, right? But you seem to have a big massive problem because I filmed your man. Right, I said, so what you're trying to say to me is you can fuck me as much as you like, right, but I'm not allowed to video it or anything, you fucking me. He went, well nah, because we don't want people to know. I said, well that don't make sense mate. To me, I say, because the only course of action I've got left now is to video it. Video everything that you fuckers have been doing to us. Right, you and the council. And he went, well, we've got a big problem here. I said, well yeah, we have got a big problem here. I said, because I'm not prepared to be messed about anymore. I said, I've put up with it for long enough and I'm not going to be put up with it again. He went, right, well I'm telling you now, right, this is where the threats come in. He said, I'm telling you now that no one will ever come to this address on their own. They're always going to be team-handed. So it's going to be two people or more will come to this address if you've got any problems. If you pull out a camera in any way, shape or form, they've had orders to pack up their stuff and leave immediately. I said, well, if they're doing their job properly, I wouldn't need to pull me cameras out. He said, we don't care about that. We just don't want you filming us making mistakes. I said, well, you know it as well as I do, mate. You've made a lot of bloody mistakes. And he said, well, anyway, about these videos. I went, yeah. He said, what's this one where you've got Keith on there and that? I said, well, I'll show you. So I started showing him all the videos. And he started like giving it the large one, and I said to him, look mate, I said, what's your point of being here? He went, well, you've had an argument with one of my men already. I said, well, it was never an argument. I said, he come here with an agenda. He come here to try and intimidate me. Would he come unstuck? Because I'm not a sort of bloke who can be intimidated too easily. And he went, well, like I've told you, no one's coming to this house, right, unless they're team-handed. I said, well, you do whatever you've got to do, mate. I really couldn't give a toss what you do anymore. I said, you've hurt us enough as a family. You can't hurt us no more. He went, anyway, I'm going to go. I said, fair enough, you go. I said, what about the window? Are you going to fix that that we've been waiting 3.5 months to fix? He went, yeah, the boys are going to do it now. Well, what they have done, basically, they haven't even fixed it. All they've done is put some draft excluder around it. The window's still bowed, so basically it needs a new window. And I said to him, well, you know it needs a new window. He said, well, we can't just fit a new window. We have to get permission from the council. I said, so will you contact the council? I said, because every time I try and contact the council for anything, I always get mugged off. I mean, well, I'll have to see. It all depends if you take any more videos or not. So I said, well, so what, you threatening me again, mate? He went, nah, it's not a threat, but I'm just telling you. I went, fair enough, are you going now? So off he toddled. But like I said, it just seems to me that no one wants to admit responsibility. No one wants to take that on the chin. And like I said, if they just come to me and said, look, we're sorry, Colin, we put you and your family through the ringer. I'm absolutely sorry about that, right? Then there's room there to negotiate in there. Do you know what I mean? It wouldn't be all this videos and getting the public to see what the Yarmouth Council and NORSE are really about. You know, I'd sort of half swallow. As long as they give me money that basically I lost from the other house, and it's been well and truly documented that they know that I lost. So there's no argument that I lost the money. It's there. It's all been documented. So I don't know. I just don't know anymore, people. I'm sort of at my wit's end, really, because I've just got this funny feeling that we're just going to go through the same old rigmarole again. I've tried to contact the council, and they're not having none of it. No one's ever got back to me. I don't know what else there is to say, people. I'll just, like I said to you before, I'll just keep you in touch with what's going on. And fingers crossed, in another 4 years, that I'll be reporting that everything's been sorted. But, like I said, I don't know. I don't know what else to say, to be honest with you. It's just an ongoing saga, innit? So keep your eyes open. I dare say that I'm going to get some more bailiffs knocking on my door. So as soon as they do turn up, straight in the face with a camera, that'll be it, basically. Just sit and wait. If you leave us some comments on what you actually think about my videos, I appreciate that. And subscribe as well if you can, please. Help me out a little bit. Alright, so thanks for watching anyway, and I'll give you another shout as soon as anything happens. Alright, thanks very much, people. Bye.